Welcome to day 20 of our 21 day prayer and devotion. What a journey so far. We have learned so many things. Just one more to go, one more day to go for us to complete this wonderful journey. We are talking about how does God usually answer our prayers. Yesterday we talked about God answers our prayers in His own time. Today we will look at another thing about the way in which God answers our prayers. It is this, that God answers our prayers in His own way. We must be willing to let God answer our prayers in His own way. Not only whenever He thinks it's the best, but however He thinks is the best. God's ways are always better and usually bigger than our ways when He answers. The Bible says in Isaiah, "My ways are not your ways. My ways are higher," God says. The reason God often delays an answer to prayer so that He can answer it in a way that is bigger and better than you thought it would be originally. What would have happened in the story that we've been discussing yesterday in Zechariah and Elizabeth's life? What would have happened in the story if God answered Elizabeth and Zechariah's request for a baby immediately? They would have had a little Jewish baby and they would have loved him or her. They would have cherished that baby and it would have been a great journey for them as husband and wife and as parents. But God delayed the request for a number of years. And then when He answered, He gave them John the Baptist, the cousin of Jesus Christ. You see, John the Baptist is called the last Old Testament prophet. The only prophet who was able to see the prophecy regarding Jesus Christ being fulfilled in his own lifetime. He was the forerunner of Messiah. John the Baptist was like this announcer, a forerunner who is coming ahead of Jesus, declaring, "Here he is, the one who is coming behind me is the Messiah," pointing to him. Because God delayed the prayer request of Zechariah and Elizabeth, they received not just another baby, they received John the Baptist. Sometimes in our hurry and asking God, you know, we push God to give us our answer very quickly and we get what only we can imagine. But if we allow God to answer in His own way, we end up in our hands with a John the Baptist, the best. God delayed Hannah's request for a son many years. But when He finally gave her a son, He gave her a Samuel, one of the greatest Old Testament prophets and judges. God does this. He does this on a regular basis in many of our lives. If we allow Him to and give Him time, God would always bring the bigger and the best to us. You see, our problem is twofold. We ask too little and we want it too quick. That's our problem. Instead of letting God work in His time and in His way to do something bigger, we don't dream big enough, we don't pray big enough, we don't think big enough, we aim too low. In Ephesians chapter 3 verses 20, Paul was trying to point that to us. But God is able to do even exceedingly above what we are able to think or imagine. You think the greatest thing that you can imagine in your imagination, God can do bigger than your imagination. That's amazing. Sometimes I believe that verse and I try to claim it. I pray, "I'm going to believe you for something impossible." And I think of the biggest thing I can pray for and think, this is really going to impress God. I pray for it and wait for the wow from God. All I get is, "Son, can you do better than that?" You know? Where's your creativity? Where's your imagination, man? I can do that with no problem. Believe me for something bigger than that. I can do above, more than what you can imagine. You see, that's the way God does that. God does it. It's like the way He gives, the way He gave is the land to Israelites. When they were led across the Red Sea and got into the promised land, God told them, "I'm going to give you this land and you're not only going to get it little by little, I'm not going to give it to you all at once, because it will overwhelm you, but you will get it little by little. But by the time you get it, everything, it'll be so huge, so beautiful. It'll be more than what you can imagine and ask for. If God really gave you all the requests you ask, it would overwhelm you. I remember reading about John D. Rockefeller, one of the richest people ever lived on the earth. Him saying this, that I would never give anybody $1 million. Why? It would ruin him. He says, if that person does not know how $1 million looks like and we give them $1 million, they wouldn't know what to do. They can't handle it. They would ruin themselves. It's almost as if God is saying the same thing to us. If God answered some of my prayers exactly as I asked them, I would have gotten short fused. I mean, his answer was much better than what I asked for. I'm thankful that God hasn't answered all my prayers. Some of them would have been disasters. I don't know what you're praying for. If you're praying for a situation, if you're praying for a relationship, if you're praying for something to happen at your workplace regarding your finances, I don't know. All of a sudden it doesn't work out, don't worry about it. God's got a plan. His plan is always the best. Let God answer in His time and in His way. Sometimes the worst thing in this world for us is to get our answers, prayers answered, you know. The prodigal son is a classic example. You remember the prodigal son who went and asked for what he wanted and he got it and he just ruined himself. So I'm glad, you know. He asked for his inheritance and he got it, he ruined it, it ruined him and he came back as no. I'm glad that God doesn't answer all our prayers sometimes. And God answers only according to His way. Think about this as we close. Leonard Ravenhill said this: God always gives His best to those who leave the choice to Him. Think that. God always gives the best to those who leave the choice to Him. Not our choices, but if we leave the choice to God, He'll always give the best. Because whatever God gives will always be the best. But whatever we ask Him, all the time would be from our own imagination, from our standard. But if we let God to give an answer for our prayers in His time, in His own way, man, it's going to be amazing. So I pray, whatever you're praying for, I request you to give God time and let God do things in His own way. God bless you.